We actually held Jared Goff and the Los Angeles Rams. Listen to this, because this is important. Hey guys, what's up? My name is Anthony, and welcome to another edition of BNA Sports Talk, and I am coming to here to report that the Giants lost again. It's like I'm talking to like my family in Afghanistan, and they don't have access to the internet or something. Well, then how would they watch this? Anyway, so the Giants lost again. And, you know, I made a preview video, but I ended up not putting it up because, I don't know, I had a little bit of fun Saturday, and then Sunday, it was another long day, and I want to preview the Giants-Rams game. And I feel like this is the best way to do it because I'm just like, yeah, I'll just do a raw opinions. I'm not going to go into the stats like the Rams are fourth in rush defense. I think the Rams are going to win this game 37-20. Go out right in front. I think that they do too many pre-stat motions. I know that we're trying to play real hard. I think we're going to score a little bit more points than we have over the past couple weeks. I think our offense is going to move well. But I just think in the end, the Rams defense, offense is going to catch up to our defense because they have good coaching means. But as far as Daniel Jones, I'm expecting him to throw at least 250 yards. I want to see somewhat competence from this offense. I want to see somewhat of a developed run game, somewhat like, oh yeah, we can build off for next week against the Dallas Cowboys. We see the Eagles now. They're losing Jason Peters. They have no offensive line. Our offensive line better be better than the Eagles. You know, you're playing in Los Angeles. There's no excuse for wind, rain, snow. There's no excuse like that. It's going to be in a dome. 40 rush attempts for 72 yards. I'm going to keep on drilling that home. We can't get much worse than that, right? Let's establish the run game a little bit. Let's start, you know, giving Daniel Jones, do some play action, spread out the field. They have no talent on defense, new defensive coordinator. We should be able to light this team up. We need to score points this game. And that's what I'm looking for. I don't care if we lose last drive or whatever. We're underdogs by 13 points. So obviously, Vegas isn't giving us much of a shot. Let's come out the game where everyone's expecting you to lose. And let's overexceed expectations. And let's win. And right now, we remind me a lot of the Miami Dolphins last year. Remember, they were 0-5, and then they finished the season 5-4 or something like that. I see a lot of fight in this team. I see a lot of Brian Flores in this team. Now, the thing is, we didn't get blown out. Besides with the San Francisco 49ers, that was an embarrassing game. It felt like we hit rock bottom the other night, and there's so many things that I want to talk about this game. First of all, we're taking no shortcuts. We're not telling Andrew Thomas to go back to his old ways of blocking. We're saying, you do it the right way. We're going to win the right way. And, you know, eventually we're going to start seeing success. That's the thing. You know, we start blocking up holes in the run game. We're starting to break free on some runs. Our offense looks good now that we're establishing the run game, that we're not getting stuff behind the line. I'd rather, instead of one run where we get 20 yards and then the rest of the runs we get zero, I'd rather just have 7 3-yard gains, to be totally honest with you, because the offense is moving the ball. You respect the run. Now, nobody's respecting our run because we don't have Saquon Barkley, and I think that we're getting a few more yards because of it. I don't know the exact truth of that statement, but I think more teams are not stacking the box. They're kind of going deeper in coverage, which, by the way, I think a big storyline later this season is going to be Austin Mack, Benjamin Victor. These guys are going to come in. I think they're going to have some big plays for this team. I think these guys are going to have big plays. I think they're going to come in. I think they're going to play pretty well. I think they have some speed. They have 4-5 speed. It's not like great speed, but I think they're going to surprise some different teams with the way that they play because not a lot of teams have tape on these guys. They don't know their tendencies just yet, and that's why Darius Slayton was so successful last year. And, yeah, as far as Daniel Jones, he was inaccurate in some passes. It may be somewhat because he feel like he's going to get hit. People are like, oh, he has no pocket awareness. I'm fine with that. I'd rather Daniel Jones rather than Dwayne Haskins. Dwayne Haskins cannot scramble whatsoever. Dwayne Haskins is just, he's a rock in the pocket. He's either getting sacked or he had a rushing touchdown the other day. You should see how pathetic and unathletic he looked on that rushing touchdown. But Daniel Jones looks athletic. He should have thrown that throw a little bit further outside, but the defensive back made a great play. And we have to stick with this team. We just have to. That's the only option right now. We have a bunch of players that are playing well. It's like a dating game at that cornerback spot. Who is it going to be this week? Corey Ballantyne, Isaac Yiadom. Eventually, one of these guys is going to have to hit, right? Eventually, one of them. You know, whether, you know, the guy has one good game, then we swap, and then we do some certain matchups. But as far as the defense, we got a little bit lucky in the beginning of the game. There were a couple of drops, but we made Jared Goff. We actually held Jared Goff and the Los Angeles Rams, listen to this because this is important, to the least amount of yards in the Sean McVay era. That is huge. That is not just something little. That is huge. They were at home. I know they had to travel to, you know, Buffalo and then back and then do all that. I don't really care. You know, we showed up this game. We fought hard. We played to win, and there were a lot of bright spots. I like how Joe Judge, he's saying he's going to play some certain players at certain spots because he knows it's a little bit of a rebuilding year. He knows. Let's get some guys some reps. Let's not try to, like, 100% win all the time. Let's look for a little bit of long-term future, and I love that. I love that mentality. Let's give these guys some looks, some in-play reps, some important reps. And Cam Fleming looks a little bit better. Andrew Thomas, you have no idea. I was texting all my friends about Andrew Thomas is a bust. You know, everyone knows how much I love Andrew Thomas. I guess not everyone, but if you listen to my videos consistently, I have a man crush on Andrew Thomas. But, it, you know, especially on one play, there was, like, a counter. It's just Mekhi Becton looks better than Andrew Thomas. So does Wills, Wirfs, all of them. I don't know what it is. Maybe it's, you know, them teaching him the exact proper technique to do it, but I'm not too sure. But as far as Daniel Jones, he's a bottom 6-7 quarterback right now in the league. He just is. Not if you've seen Brian Hoyer tonight, I've been watching the Patriots game. He's better than Brian Hoyer, I guess so. He's better than, like, a Dwayne Haskins. His QBR right now is around a 46, a 47, so it's a little bit below average. I think that he needs to be a little bit more accurate, but he's not getting helped that much by wide receivers dropping balls. The ball's in your hand. You got to catch it. And, you know, the balls are going to be a foot. He missed Evan Engram on a crosser. I'm pretty sure we've all seen that play by now. We have to stick with Daniel Jones. I think he's showing improvement. People say he's regressing. I think he's showing improvement. The down the field accuracy has kind of slipped this year because we haven't been doing it that much. The thing is, with a bunch of quarterbacks, they get a bunch of help from the wide receivers. Take a look at Patrick Mahomes. He can make those tight window throws, but it really helps when the guy's wide open downfield. It just does. When you have a Tyreek, you have somebody like that, and I really do think that these wide receivers that we're going to be bringing in, hopefully, towards the end of the year, are going to help us. Remember, we don't have Saquon. I think he would help our offense. I was kind of wrong about that. I would say that's something I'm wrong about. I'm like, oh, Saquon wasn't really helping our offense out. He kind of is. Like, it is kind of helpful to bust out, like, a 70-yard gain and have a touchdown like that every game. It really does. It's like, you know that one time he's going to bust out and really help spring our offense, but the running game looks better. You know, we're showing signs of actually improving, and this team now starts seeing it. They're starting to see the results of their work. Now, if we keep on getting blown out, maybe not. But like the Miami Dolphins, I think this is a 5-11 team. I think we're going to win 5 games this year. And, you know, we have a tough schedule. We have a really rough schedule. Like, we play the Dallas Cowboys. I'll give my preview a little bit later in the week because I don't want to talk about everything now. But we have to score points this game. We do. If Daniel Jones can beat Dak Prescott in a shootout, that's really going to build confidence in this team. I think the offensive line and the wide receivers are losing a little bit of confidence in him. But we all know the issue of Daniel Jones staring down the wide receivers. I think it's going to improve. I really do. When he learns the offense a little bit better, when he fully understands it, it comes with reps. It comes with a bunch of things. And yeah, I think that it comes with a bunch of things. I don't know what I'm saying. It's kind of like one of those filler words. But yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed the video. That's a quick post-game recap. I've only been talking about 6 minutes, but get on with the rest of your night. I don't really feel like adding much of a video. And I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye, guys.